What is up, BBO crew? This is your boy, Perfect Blue, here with week 3 of the Banless Battlers League, where your San Diego State Zelfs will be taking on the Puffy Pachirisus, coached by Sparks the God. So we're both going into this game 1-1, and I mentioned this last week, but I decided to make some changes to my team. As you can see, there is a depressed Manaphy on your screen. So we are going to be dropping Manaphy, along with Diancie, Alolan Dugtrio, and Zangoose, in exchange for Togekiss, Metagross, Quagsire, and Frogadier. So why would I do this? Frogadier, nice T-Spiker and Spiker, really like that, basically. Quagsire, Unaware Wall, for some of the mons that rely on setup a bit, Quagsire can be really nice. And the two main things, Togekiss gives me a nice bulky fairy, something to actually like take hits and prevent like dragons from just completely destroying me, along with Metagross. So Metagross, the one thing dragons have to be able to touch this thing will probably be the ground type attacks. Togekiss will be able to obviously switch into those, and Togekiss is weak to poison and poisons rock and steel, obviously, and Metagross resists all of those. So basically, if a dragon wants to be able to sweep me, it will need, obviously it's Dragon Stab, but it'll need two more moves to be able to, really beat my team. The exception is Zardex, but that one's bulky. Not bulky, but, it's busted. So, like, yeah, you can't beat Zardex ever. So why did we decide to drop Manaphy? I just felt Manaphy didn't really work with the thing I want, with what I wanted to do with the team. It really relied on Volturn into trapping with Mega Gengar. I felt like Manaphy, well, it is a good mon, probably didn't fit the team as well as I would have liked it to. Diancie, I really wanted Togekiss, so that was kind of the thing with Diancie. And then Alolan Dugtrio and Zangoose are just dog, so yeah, they're really bad Pokemon, so yeah, I kind of had to drop those. So yeah, that's the changes I decided to make. So let's get into the team we are up against. We're against Sparks the God, and his team consists of the Rayquaza, Excadrill, Tapu Lele, Ribombee, Melodic, Golbat, Solrock, Mega Tyranitar, Gengar, and Pachirisu. So Sparks loves Pachirisu, gotta prepare for the threat, can be a very scary Pokemon, yada yada yada. So yeah, he's a Rayquaza. First 2 weeks we went in against a Zygarde 100, a Zygarde 50, and now a Rayquaza. So like, the dragons keep on coming. Scary thing about Rayquaza is it can be physical or special, and like, there's nothing I can really do about it. But what's nice with the Togekiss and Metagross is now that I have those two mons, he really is forced to pick his coverage. So he probably wants dragon coverage, that's nice. Needs something to hit the Metagross, so probably Earthquake or V-Create. And then for the Togekiss, V-Create plus Dragon Claw kind of hits everything. But does he really want the defense drops? We don't know. And like, E-Speed is a thing that, like, I do expect him to run, because Abomasnow can pick it off with an Ice Shard, and obviously E-Speed will be able to out-prioritize that. So, yeah, that's really what my thoughts are on Rayquaza. Tapu Lele, very scary mon to switch into. I'm not looking forward to playing against that. Excadrill kinda destroys me, with Mold Breaker. Like, I played Zygarde, then Excadrill. Like, dude, the ground spam, come on. Because I have, like, Hydreigon, Ezelf, Electros. They don't like Mold Breaker 1,000 Arrows. Like, come on, guys. And, yeah, so that's going to be very annoying to deal with. But I do have some sets in mind that will be able to take on the drill. Just because, like, Mold Breaker is just very scary against my team. Tapu Lele, if he's Scarf, he can't necessarily just win with one move, which is nice. If he is not Scarf and he kills me, Mega Gengar can trap it. So that's just something to keep in mind. I do expect, like, maybe a Kebbia Berry to be able to take a hit from the Mega Gengar, as Shadow Ball obviously wouldn't do as much damage, and I would want to secure the kill on the Tapu Lele. Ribombee, webs, very annoying. Yeah, Ribombee, of Mega Gengar, I'm not too scared, but, and, like, Metagross, so that's really nice. Melodic's very annoying, just for my team in general. My grass type isn't Abomasnow. Well, it is bringable, I don't want to rely on it to really break the Melodic, and an Electros is my, electric type, and that's not really the most offensive mon. It's a really nice, like, typing plus ability to be able to really have no weakness, except the first 3 weeks here, it really has had a weakness. Golbat, don't really expect Golbat. It can come though, maybe. It's a Golbat. Does Golbat things. I guess the team that I'm actually bringing, Golbat, is very scary though. Solrock, I do not expect Solrock. Move on. Mega Titar can come. If it's Spidef, it can really take a hit from the Mega Gengar and be able to pursuit trap it. That can be very annoying. His own Gengar. A Scarf Gengar could be very scary and annoying for my team to deal with, just because I don't have the best switch-ins to it. And Pachirisu, it sparks. It's really 50-50 on if he brings this thing. It's not like a team matchup thing. It's just, you know, Sparks is the Pachirisu whisper. So yeah, let's get into the team I'm bringing. The first mon we have here is our Mega Gengar with the Shadow Ball, Icy Wind, Sludge Wave, Focus Blast, just 4 attacks. Enough speed for Ribombee. Yeah, pretty self-explanatory. Trap stuff, yada yada yada. Metagross is here with the Meteor Mash, Bullet Punch, Pursuit, Earthquake. I really wanted Ice Punch to be able to prevent Rayquaza from setting up on me, but I really did prioritize all four of these moves over it. Earthquake's just nice for the Excadrill. This is kind of a drill lure, as I don't have much to beat the drill, and obviously I need Earthquake for that. So Pursuit, really nice for chipping down the Tapu Lele. If he is a Choice Scarf variant, I can go into my Metagross and be able to Pursuit Trap it and get some damage off on it. And the speed is to creep the Melodic a little bit. And, well, I don't need Metagross to necessarily outspeed it. It does help with another mon to be able to tell me what speed exactly this Melodic will be. Next, we have Hydreigon. Pretty bulky, with Taunt, Dark Pulse, Ruse, U-Turn. This thing is designed to be, if he is Scarf, Mold Breaker, Excadrill, this thing can take it on pretty well. That is really nice. I wanted Taunt just so I could Taunt a Rayquaza setting up. I do not have the Dragon move, and Taunt allows me to deal with Melodic a little bit more, those kinds of things. Dark Pulse is just relatively nice stab against his team, and then U-Turn to be able to pivot into other threats, such as my Mega Gengar, if you wanted to go into, I guess, Melodic against my Mega Gengar, or against my Hydreigon, I could U-Turn into the Mega Gengar, and as long as it is chipped down enough, my Mega Gengar will be able to trap and kill that thing. Next mon we have is Azelf, just with a Life Orb, Psychic, Shadow Ball, Grass Knot, Nasty Plot. Grass Knot's really nice to be able to hit Melodic and Mega Titar. Psychic Shadow Ball kind of hits the rest of his team. The speed here is going to be for the Mega regular Gengar. And then Nasty Plot, just in case I really am struggling with Melodic, I will need to be able to Nasty Plot and kill that thing. Next we have Infernape with a Choice Scarf, Close Combat, U-Turn, Stone Edge, EQ. Really, because Scarf Excadrill and a plus one Rayquaza, you know, Tapu Lele, those things can be annoying. The thing I really do regret is no fire coverage, but you'll see why, like, that might may or may not matter in the actual battle. And then we have Guilty Kiss, or Togekiss, with Wish Protect, Dazzling Lane, Defog. I don't have Air Slash, so I'm just going to put Super Luck on it and hope we are able to get crits and stuff. So yeah, that will be the team, and let's get right into the battle. Oh, shoot. Yeah, here it is. So, as you can see, Sparks decided to bring the Ribombee, Pachirisu, Melodic, Excadrill, Tapu Lele, and Rayquaza. So no Gengar or Mega Titar, that's very surprising. As you can see, the Pachirisu is a threat right here. So, yeah, we're going to lead off with Metagross, though. Something I realized before starting this game is that I do not have rocks on this team, and that is very annoying against the Ribombee, as if he is Sash, he will be able to keep it. So yeah. I'm going to lead off with $W, the Metagross, you know, the $W. So here he leads off with two scarves, and yeah, it has a scarf, that's cool. And so I'm just going to go for the Meteor Mash, I believe, and this is just because, while I did expect him to switch, he could have just got up webs, and that could have been very embarrassing if I were to pursue. But looking back, pursuit could have been a play, so we don't know. He does reveal to be the Flame Orb Melodic, so that is nice information to know. Here, I'm just going to switch out into my Hydreigon, as it can take on this thing relatively well, as long as he does not poison me on the switch-in. But here, he is going to double out into the Pachirisu, so yeah, I do not know what this thing does, so it is scary in that way. And here, he's going to actually withdraw it and go back into his Ribombee, as I'm just going to taunt it, because, like, dude, I don't know what the, I don't know what Pachirisu does. Like, he could have nuzzled me, that could have been annoying, but that would have meant that, Melodic would have had a difficult time beating Hydreigon. So, yeah, I'm just going to go into my Metagross. He is actually going to U-turn, so I'm thinking, okay, is this actually a scarf of Ribombee? Because he did name it two scarves, so you never know. He's going to go back out into his Melodic. Flame Orb is going to help because he is going to have to recover at some point. I do understand, though, as it really just shuts down a physical Infernape. So, yeah, I'm just going to go back into my Hydreigon, and he's just going to go for the Scald, as not going to do that much, obviously, as he actually does get a crit, so that's actually pathetic damage if you think about it. Hydreigon's just amazing in that way. So here he's going to withdraw this and go into his Pachirisu. I believe I just Dark Pulse this. Oh no, I just U-turn. And what the U-turn reveals, actually, is that he is a Spidef Pachirisu. So, you know, Spidef, to be able to eat the Mega Gengar hit and nuzzle, you know how it is. So, I'm just going to go out into Metagross to threaten this thing out. He's going to go back into his Melodic, though, as I'm just going to EQ, I believe. So, yeah, I'm just going to EQ. That's going to do some damage, but this Melodic will be very annoying for me to break, as the Flame Orb does kind of shut down my Metagross's ability to be able to break this, and I do not want to get Scald burned. So here I'm just going to withdraw and go into my Azelf, as I know he has to recover here to avoid getting two-shot. So here I can really just play around with what I want to do. I believe I do just set up a Nasty Plot just to be able to break something. I don't expect him to really play too aggressive and go hard into, like, Ribombee or something like that, but that's exactly what he does as I click Nasty Plot. So that is very annoying, as I do not want to stay in against this thing. If it is Scarf, like, it obviously there's nothing I can do about it. I mean, I can kill it, but I do want to keep my Azelf around to be able to break the Melodic later. So here I'm just going to go into my Togekiss, as he is just going to go for the Moonblast. And that reveals that he is a max special attack, so Choice Scarf still is a possibility. But as you can see here, he is going to actually U-turn, so he is not Choice Scarf. You know, two scarves, Sparks playing those mind games. And yeah, he's going to go right into his Pachirisu, so very, very scary threat here. As I believe I just get up a Wish, yeah, and Wish, kind of nice just to pass a Wish into something. And, yeah, Togekiss clicks Wish. Okay, so here I'm just going to go out into my Metagross, I believe. And, what that'll allow me to do is gain some health back, as I believe he just goes for the Nuzzle, yeah. So, he's going to paralyze this, do that nice 6 damage, but the Wish is going to come back and be able to heal my Metagross. So, because he hasn't seen an item on this thing, he could really expect anything. So, yeah, that's probably why he's playing around this a bit. But here he's just going to vote for the Volt Switch, as I did predict him to go into Melodic on my Metagross, but yeah, he it's a Pachirisu, it can Volt Switch, so very scary annoying Mon. Here I have to switch out, I do not want to lose this thing, as I'm just going to go into my Togekiss, as it will be able to take hits from this relatively well. He does reveal Sticky Webs, but once he revealed the U-turn, it was just like, yeah, I don't think you're Quiver Dance, so I don't think you can break this thing. And I can easily just defog the webs away, as U-turn is going to do 4 again, and my leftovers will get that plus more back, so very nice. He's going to actually choose to go into his Melodic, as this kind of shows that he probably does have the Toxic to be able to poison my Togekiss, and I do not want to get poisoned, obviously, so yeah, I kind of have to switch out here, as I'm just going to pull the switch into Hydreigon, as hard Metagross isn't a thing, and I do not want to just go hard into my Mega Gengar at this point in the game. Yeah, I just don't want to do that. So, Toxic goes off, poisons my Hydreigon, and yeah, very annoying that I'm poisoned. But with leftovers and roost, I will be able to stay on the field a bit longer, and with taunt, I will be able to residually chip this thing, as he is not leftovers, and that could be very annoying to him. But here he's just going to withdraw and go into his Pachirisu, as the threat is out again, as I'm just going to click the Dark Pulse, and that confirms he is Spidef, because the U-turn did as much as the Dark Pulse, and that is very scary. So yeah, Pachirisu is back in though. I don't really know what this thing will go for, so I'm just going to Dark Pulse again, as he decides to stay in, and he goes for the Super Fang. So yeah, it goes through the Super Fang, and that is a thing, I guess. Thinking back, he could have been AV. I don't know. Like, I didn't care enough to calc the nuzzle damage. So here I'm just going to U-turn, as I can keep this alive to be able to taunt the Melodic, but he is going to just live on one. Very annoying. I can go into my Azelf, as I feel the Super Fang is coming again, and I can just kill something with my Azelf here, basically, and that'll be very nice. So here I'm just going to Psychic, and the threat is gone, boys, and it is actually 7 minutes into the battle, and the first Mon will be able to go down here. I do reveal the Life Orb, so he can just go back into his Rabombi and click U-turn. There's nothing I can do about this, and yeah, at this point in the match, I'm thinking, okay, Infernape might be able to win late game. I just need to eliminate his threats in a way that I can win with one move. So I'm just going to go back into my Togekiss here, Guilty Kiss, you know how it is. And yeah, Rabombi's going to go back. He goes into his Melodic, and I'm thinking, yeah, he wants to poison me, definitely. I cannot let Togekiss get poisoned, because it is able to, because my Hydreigon's weakened, and if my Metagross gets paired, Scarf Excadrill with EQ will be able to clean me, so I do need this to stay healthy, as well as like take hits from the Tapu Lele somewhat. So here he is just going to recover, and very annoying. But my plan is, okay, I think I can win without my Hydreigon, so what I'm going to do is just taunt, Dark Pulse this thing down, trap it with Mega Gengar, all will be good, all will be fun, you know how it is. So yeah, I'm just going to go for the Dark Pulse here, and knowing that he will not recover, obviously, on that turn. So here he is just going to Scald, and I'm just going to taunt him this turn, as he will take Flame Orb damage, and Mega Gengar will be able to beat this thing, as he will be at a range where Sludge Wave has a chance to KO, but at the same time, like, he can't do anything back, so it really will be fine. And here he can't recover, obviously, so I can just go into my Mega Gengar here, as Hydreigon will fall to the poison damage, so, or toxic damage, rather. So yeah, Hydreigon goes down. This thing is a bit above half, but because he is Flame Orb, I am expecting more defensive. So here I can just go into Mega Gengar. I'm not Mega, so I don't trap it, but here he's going to stay in, so I'm like, okay, he just wants to lose his Melodic. And because he doesn't have Mega T-Tar, he will not be able to switch into this thing very well. So here, Sludge Wave is going to go off, and it is going to do a lot of damage against this thing, but he is going to live and Mirakomi, so see a Mega Gengar, and that is very bad. Very, very bad, yeah. So, yeah, Melodic is here. I'm just going to go into my Togekiss, though, as I can, just Dazzling Gleam and beat this thing, but yeah, that is very annoying to lose my Mega Gengar like that. Here he's going to go into his Tapu Lele, and what this actually reveals is, this is very helpful information, the Dazzling Gleam damage reveals that he is a bulky Tapu Lele, if not AV. So I'm like, okay, this makes sense, because AV will be able to take hits from Mega Gengar relatively well. So I'm just going to protect as, you know, can't be 100% sure. I kind of want to see what he goes for, and if I can waste psychic train turns, that could be nice. So here he's going to click Psy Shock. I'm just going to go into my Metagross, I believe. And, yeah, just in case, on the off chance, he is a bulky Specs. But here he's just going to Shadow Ball, and then it'll be very annoying as, yeah, he does reveal to be Max Special Attack. So, obviously, I cannot stay in here. So, yeah, I feel that he has to click Shadow Ball, though, just in case I stay in with my Metagross and decide to sack it, as he does not want to lose his Tapu Lele. But, yeah, Togekiss will be able to take that relatively well. I can just protect if I wanted to, but here I'm just deciding to, you know, eat that, because he is Psy Shock, not Psychic, and I am a defensive Togekiss, so he actually struggles to break this thing. Because Pachirisu went down to be able to, like, nuzzle me, and because Melodic is weakened, he cannot really do anything to this Togekiss. And, yeah, his best bet's, like, Rayquaza. But here he's just gonna go out into his Excadrill, and, yeah, so I'm just gonna Gleam as long as he doesn't crit me, I can live. I could have lived that, or no, he wasn't in terrain, so, yeah, he wasn't killing me, so I could have just Gleamed, you know, get some damage off. This Excadrill reveals that he does not have much bulk. Here he's just gonna switch out back into Tapu Lele. So this kind of got me thinking, okay, yeah, he's just pivoting that in so that he could have more chances with his Tapu Lele. But this Togekiss will be able to eventually beat the Tapu Lele, so that is pretty cool. So, yeah, I can just Wish Protect on this thing pretty easily, and maybe one time try to go into my Metagross, try to be a bit sneaky, and be able to pursue this or something like that, and that can be really cool. But, yeah, so I'm just going to throw up a wish here, and I believe now I try to be cheeky and go into my Metagross. And as you're going to see here, he clicks the Psy Shock. We got him, boys. Just kidding. He clicks Shadow Ball, and I lose my Metagross, and the wish is dead. So, yeah, very bad. Kind of a bad play by me, but I didn't need Metagross, and because it was paired, it could have been set up fodder to the Rayquaza, potentially. So, very annoying. Here, I have to protect. Yeah, just because I wasn't able to get a wish into my Togekiss, so here he's just going to Psy Shock again, obviously. I can Wish Protect one more time, Psychic Drain will be out, all will be good for my Togekiss, as, yeah. He does have 5 bonds, though, so that is very annoying to deal with, as I am down 3-5 right now. But I can just throw up the wish right here. He did not crit, bless, and, yeah. I can just, I have to protect on this turn, or if Psychic Terrain disappears, which it does, I will be able to, as long as he doesn't crit me, that's pretty cool. So, I can just kind of, like, attack here if I wanted to. So, here he's going to go back out into his Excadrill. Mold Breaker reveals again, so, yeah. Gleam's going to go off. It does something to it, like, yeah, not too much, around 23-24%, if I were to guess. So, yeah, which does come off. I can just protect here, see what he wants to do, as I am 100% expecting a Scarf Mold Breaker here, and he's just going to go for the Earthquake. I can just stay in and Dazzling Gleam now, because I'm that confident, and even if you did Iron Head, like, it would have been bad, but it wouldn't have been the end of the world. Here, he's just going to EQ again, as I can just go for the Gleam, as he probably did expect me to double out or something, on the Iron Head into my Infernape, probably, and he wanted to be able to beat that. So, yeah, he's just going to switch out here. I can just Gleam again. He's going to pick his Tapu Lele, and Yeah, Psychic Turn will be back up, and Togekiss, Guilty Kiss will click the Dazzling Gleam. I have not gotten a crit, though, and with Super Luck, that is very sad. So, Psyshock is going to come off and, do something, but I can just throw up a wish here and be able to Dazzling Gleam and live the next one if I wanted to. As long as he didn't crit me, that was fine. So I'm going to play the odds and not get crit here, as I am a go and I do not get crit, because Togekiss is just that thing. So yeah, Dazzling Gleam will finally get a crit, and I don't know how much that mattered too much, because it did seem like Dazzling Gleam 4 or 5 would have killed, but this just guarantees that 4 Dazzling Gleams would have killed. Here I can just protect, kind of, just because why not, and he is going to go for the Psyshock again. So yeah, Togekiss will get some lefties back, very annoying Pokemon. I love Wish Protect just because Choice Scarf things are Choice Specs. And yeah, he's going to go out into his Excadrill again as, I'm just going to throw up a wish just because I can. Because Psychic Drain does run out this turn, so I will have been able to live the next one and get a Gleam off. But here, if he was Iron Head, then obviously he could click it. He's just going to go for the Rocks, though. I do not want to get flinched or anything, so I'm just gonna stay in and Dazzling Gleam. You know how it is. He will be at a range where he is almost dead. One more will do it. And because he is, Scarf, or presumably, I'm playing around like him being Scarf. I'm just, you know, that good. He's gonna go back out into his Melodic and actually sack this thing to get a free switch in to either his, Rayquaza or his, Tapu Lele, but here I'm just gonna defog as I'm just that good. So no rocks up, really cool. Gleam, gonna go off, and because I am Gleam, I will be able to guarantee two-shot the Rayquaza, so that is really cool. Snek comes out, so that is going to be Rayquaza. And I'm just gonna attack this thing, because this thing is a threat. I do not want to deal with this, so he's obviously gonna go for the Dragon Dance, and I can take, any hit that he wants to go to, as long as it's not a Z-move, but because this is BBL, Ubers will not allow to be Z-move Mons. So Dazzling Gleam, obviously a two-shot. If I did crit, that would have been a Poggers, but you know how it is. Dragon Ascent will come off, and it'll do a lot of damage, actually, to my Togekiss, but I will be able to take it, because Guilty Kiss is just that thing. So, Gleam, Rayquaza dead. But I'm at a range where Tapu Lele could be able to kill me, so that is going to be, bad, but, yeah. So, his last two Mons are going to be the Drill and the Tapu Lele, so what I'm thinking is, that's a Choice Scarf Drill. I do not want to lose to one move. I will need to be able to keep my Infernape plus Togekiss alive to be able to beat his team. Oh, did he have Rabombi? Yeah, no, he did have Rabombi. What am I on? Oh my gosh. Yeah, so, yeah, he does have Rabombi, so, yeah, he's just gonna Psyshock. I'm just gonna sack my Azelf here, as I can just go into Infernape, and because it is weakened, I will be able to threaten this thing, and, yeah, so, poor Azelf, his first death of the season, but that will be okay, as I can just go out into the Infernape here, and, be able to act accordingly. So here comes Calgary, and, I'm just going to U-turn, as it will be able to kill this thing, and thank god it killed this thing. So, it is Excadrill and Rabombi versus Togekiss and Infernape. He does not know my Infernape set, obviously, so that is really nice. I am Scarf, obviously, so that will be able to be really nice against his team, as he just goes out into his Excadrill. I have to protect here, kind of see what he locks into, as... yeah, I can just protect, and that's easy like that. So here, he is actually going to click the Iron Head, so I can go hard into my Infernape here, and be totally fine. If he wanted to go into Rabombi, I will be able to outspeed it, because I'm a Choice Scarf Infernape, obviously. So, yeah, he's going to go out into his Rabombi here, as I believe I just go out into my Infernape here, yeah. And I can just U-turn, because I still don't know if this is... Sash, so I don't want to, like, mess around with that too much. So here I can just U-turn, go out into my Togekiss, and barring rules, I should be able... Not barring rules, barring, like, I guess getting crit or anything like that, Togekiss should be able to take this on. So he is going to go for the Moonblast here, and as you can see, that does a bit of damage as... I believe that did about 46, so... Yeah, I need to protect here to be able to, take some... Or actually, why can't I do that? I just gleam. Wow, I'm a god. Oh yeah, okay. I kind of expected him to, get up webs there, I believe. Just because, Drew will be able to clean from there, potentially. But here, I'm going to knock him down to... Yeah, I'm going to live that one so he gets a bit of a higher roll, if you know how it is. And, yeah, I can defog the webs away and just spam defog, honestly, because I do not want him to keep the webs up. But here, I'm just going to pull the switch into his Infernape. I do live a Moonblast, so that'll be cool, as I will be able to take this Moonblast, and that'll be cool for my Infernape. But because I'm not a Fire Move, remember that part? I have to Stone Edge here, so I will be able to land the Stone Edge, yeah, killing this Ribombee, as I can just go out into my Togekiss here, and what that'll do is secure the game, as I do not want to miss Stone Edges. He can, you know, Iron Head stuff, yeah, yada yada. So I have to switch out into my Togekiss here, and that 100% secures the game, because webs are not on the field. My Infernape has Close Combat and Earthquake. Here he's just going to go for the Iron Head. That is totally fine. It was never my play to stay in and risk the game like that. I'm just going to go out into my Infernape and win the game against Sparks. Oh my gosh, what a game, what a game. I'm just going to go for the close combat here, and San Diego State Azelfs, a 1-0 victory. Togekiss just put the team on its back. You know, this is why you pick ones up like that. So yeah, I'm actually going to load this picture. Oh, yeah, okay, that's fine. Anyways, yeah, Togekiss put the team on his back. You know how it is. And we will go to 2-1. Next week, we are against Aaron, 2-20, coach of the Calgary Infernapes. So, yeah, that is a GG to Sparks. Oh, that was a really hype game, honestly. I was so excited. Yeah, Togekiss is just so good. And I guess this is what happens when you name your Pokemon after Love Live, just a sign. Anyways, yeah, see you in the next one, and peace.